from trysupermarket.com. Today, I'm going to show you and go through the different procedures of fitting a kitchen. Right, today, I'm going to show you how to set out a kitchen. It's basically quite a relatively simple one. It's just an L shape. We've got a CAD drawing from the manufacturers, which you'll normally get a site visit, but always check your sizes anyway. Just make sure everything fits before we start cutting anything about, yeah? So what we're going to do here, because we've got, this is where the L shape starts, we've got to create a corner out of two cupboards with a corner post. So ideally, it's always better to start from the corner and work either way, checking your levels at all times. So I'm going to place this in here. I've checked the level of the floors, it's not too bad. Basically, somewhere around there, just loosely, insert that there. Obviously, nothing's been levelled up yet. Right, to create your corner, basically what it says on here, this is our sink unit with our drainer to the left. So, what I've done here, I've got this one ready. Obviously all the cupboards are empty, there's no doors on them, just to keep it nice and locked. Right, the datum here is quite crucial because we have a washing machine and a fridge freezer. So basically, multiples of 600. We don't really want it tight, it's nice to put some sort of infill in because obviously if it's too tight the door might bind on the wall or the washing machine may not open correctly. Right, so I've got basically got 1220 there, which gives me 20 mil. Now if you can see here, what we've got to do to create this corner, we've set this door out at 400. So basically your corner post wants to basically sit like so. You see that? So it won't hinder our door opening. Now the problem we've got here is, if you look under there, this is all existing pipework. Now I've looked at this already and it's very tight. If I was to move that carcass up to that pipework, which again it's all original, if it was basically new stuff we could have showed the plumber exactly where to go. So if I push this cupboard back here, see that? We're basically out about 8 mil. Nothing's level yet. So what I want to do is we see where this pipe is. Ideally, if there was a carcass going next to it, I'd just cut that out of a jigsaw. But because we're actually going to see this until the washing machine goes in, it's only 8 mil, I'm going to use a trimmer to trim out the access to the cupboard around the pipe, like so. Well, what I've done, straight cutter, yeah, I've set it half the depth. We need an 8 mil, but 8 mil's sort of like that. It's too much, too aggressive to take all that out in one go. So what we're going to do, set it about halfway. We'll check the size when I set it up again, okay? Don't put your fingers near it. Basically, what I'm going to do now is work right the way across here. Well, what we're going to do now, as I explained, we've gone through basically halfway, okay? It's a lot tighter than cutting it all out. As I say, what we're going to do is set that to 8 mil now, okay? We've already gone down 4 mil, so we're just taking an additional 4 mil out. So basically, we're just going to do exactly what we've done before, but it'll be slightly deeper. Thank you. done is, you can see, we've removed the melamine coating from the inside of the cupboard, which is not a problem. We've still maintained the other side, which I wanted to. Now, because it's porous and you're just looking at the natural timber now, or natural timber, natural chipboard, I don't want to get any water in there. We'll go through this when we do the sink as well, because it's really important to seal up any edges that we've exposed. Okay, let that go off. It'll take 5-10 minutes. Okay. And as you can see, because we haven't cut all of this out, we've still maintained a lot of strength in the cupboard. That's about it. That is a waterproof one. Make sure you use the waterproof one, yeah? Right. This basically where it was before. You will see, you can come around here, you will see where I've cut out now, it just fits in there just right. Yeah, and if you ever look the other side, look, I said, like, it's maintained everything. We've got some cables in the way here, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to mark these out to set this cupboard back exactly flush. Normally, the cupboards are the right depth of normally about 585. Just checking that, because by the time your door goes on, 575, by the time your door goes on, it brings it out to 595, because your worktop 600. Just make sure that all covers, because some kitchens, some modular kitchens, come out shy, which means you may have to bring them off the wall, but in this case you don't have to. Just where your cables are, if there's anything in the way, it's fractional. I'm just going to take that out, just to offer that back. Check the other side as well. If you're looking here, you've got the same problem as well where they run the cable out. Okay, so we're going to do the same here. Okay, keep it as tidy as you can. I know you don't see it, and what we are going to do, which I did earlier, took the back out. There was a back in here, but there's so many pipes and bits and pieces in there. What we're going to do later is basically recut the back and put it back in, but make sure we can get to all these services. Okay? What we're going to do now, carefully, I'm just going to trim this out for these two cables. If you have a look there, this is quite important. Wherever you've got appliances going, you'll have to allow for the floor as well. Okay? So depending on how high your freestanding cooker is, if it's built in, it's not too bad. But if you've got anything integral or anything to go under a work surface, always check for the sizes and always allow for your floor. So what I've done here, we need from the floor 870. The work surface is 40mm. Okay, which gives us 19. Again, you'll be governed by your appliances, so it's better to have a little bit more room under there than not enough. Okay? So what we're going to do now, set this up, we're going to adjust the first cupboard. Now, in this day and age, 99% of the kitchen cupboards will have adjustable feet on. So basically, we want to get all levels correct. So we want the front level, we want the back level, and just as important, from left to right level. And all you basically do is, if you see down here, you twist the legs, okay, like so, up and down, just to get your level. Okay, so that's pretty good with the front. Okay, now the back. Again, all you've got to do is twist our wrap rod down, like so, left to right. Make sure there's no rocking in the cupboard as well. You can see that it's got to go quite a bit. You see that? It's got to go quite a bit higher at the back. So what we're doing, twist that one around. Making sure. Okay, Take the time with this because it's really important that it's correct because of your tiles, which I'll go through later when we come to fit the worktops. Okay, I'm happy with that. Right, what we've done, this is completely level now in all four points, left to right, front to back. Now I've just offered this cupboard to create a corner. It's always easier to get the corner right and work off both ends, okay? So what I'm going to do now is level this cupboard up to this one. Basically, it's exactly the same. All you've got to do is wind up your feet, or wind them down if necessary, okay, to get it plumb with the other cupboard. It's crucial where they join, it's got to be exactly level. Okay, so if you see that, it's pretty good there. If you look into the corner, the reason it's got to be level is when we join the work surfaces, we don't want the work surfaces travelling up or down. So that's pretty good there. Again, this is crucial. Across the back. Yeah, so that wants to come up a bit. That wants to come up a bit as well. Okay, we can actually see it needs to come up if you look at the other cupboard. Alright? It's easier for the two of you, one keeping it on a level if you have to get under the cupboards. Keep it back to the wall. Pretty good. You see what we created, a corner level in every way. Right, when we're happy with our levels, what we're going to do is fix the carcasses back to the wall securely. Just check it's all level again, yeah? These are preferably my favourite. They're like a stretcher plate, okay? With the elongated holes. Now, we don't want to penetrate the other side of the cupboard, so what we're going to do, just check you've got the adequate size screws. We don't want to be coming through the face. Okay, what we do, place the plate like so. Okay, just a little mark here, like so. Okay, now with a masonry drill, obviously, only if it's we're going to brickwork, which we are. Carefully. See what we will do. Let's take the cupboard out for what it's worth. We know where the cupboard goes, okay? What we're going to do, just mark where the cupboard goes. Don't drag the cupboard because it adjusts the legs. So what we're going to do, we'll carefully lift that out and place it. So we now see our marks on the wall. Right, we don't really have to go very deep. It's only basically holding the cover back to the wall. So realistically, a 2-inch screw will be sufficient enough just to hold that back. It's quite important to go through the plaster or the bonding and try and get into some of the brickwork just for a better fixing. So what we're going to do is drill on our mark. When you place this cover back in here, it wouldn't hurt just to check it's level. Because I've placed it carefully, the feet shouldn't have moved, but okay, bang them in. Just pop them just below the plaster line and plug it into the brickwork. Okay. Do it carefully. Place the cover back just to check nothing's moved. Okay. Yeah, that's fine. So all we do now is fix our stretcher to the wall. Okay, put it to the wall first. Okay, you see that? If it's a little bit awkward, pull the cover out again. I should be able to get this one. sure it's nice and firm. And make sure it's on that line, because it is quite crucial to keep everything square. It doesn't matter how many times you want to check your level. Make sure that's back to the wall with the smaller screw. Okay, what we're going to do, you can pilot it if you want, but these self-tappers normally go in pretty good. Right, so just make sure it's back and tight. Okay, and all you do is the same on this side. Right, basically, that's your adjustable feet. Now, different manufacturers, they're changed slightly, but they're all basically the same idea. You've got a threaded lower part, yeah, for adjustment on the floor. What's important, if you can see that, yeah, there's like a flange there, it's crucial, if you come around here, that sits over side of the carcass. Then the reason for this is kitchen cupboards do take a lot of weight. Now if you were to put it on there, what may happen in time is the base will weaken. Having it like that, it holds it all together. Yeah, again, using the right size screws, you don't want screws coming through the base of your cupboard. Just check, we'll take that off, I'll just show you. Just check you've got the right size screws. There you go. Okay. Yeah, that's great. Okay, just right. So basically what you do, place the upper parts, you see, over there. There's four on smaller cupboards, sometimes on a meter cupboard or a larger base cupboard, like a 900, you'd have one in the middle as well. Right, screw them in. It's important to screw them all the holes that are exposed. Don't just put two in just thinking it'll be okay. You need 4-inch one. And then the lower part fits in like so. What I tend to do is measure off the other cupboards which we started to fit to get a rough idea, and you can adjust them when it's in place. Right, what you need to do now, we create that corner. Now, it doesn't matter if you're going to run 5 units, 10 units, 20 units, you've got to come off plumb. So what we've done, same again, adjusted the legs as so. When we're happy, it's quite crucial that these faces are plumb. So before we screw it together, it's just handy to put a couple of clamps on there, because you can always move the clamps. So, I'll just bring it out slightly. Okay, so basically, we're happy with that, that's quite rigid, it's not fixed to the back yet, but again, just check. It's crucial it's level, because the work surface will follow the lines of the carcasses. Now if the carcasses are not straight, the work surface will start running out, and then the tiling are running out, so it's quite crucial to get it all plumb. Okay, what we'll do now, again, just check the size of your screws. Right, just check the size of your screws. Again, we don't want to penetrate through into the other carcass. So I'm basically on these, it's 18mm and 18mm, which is 36mm. I'm going to use 1¼-inch, which is ample, to hold that cupboard together. What's a good idea? Try and screw where you're not going to visibly see the screw. So it's a good idea. Get right up there. Now, you can, if it works out right, you can screw behind the hinge plate, which I'll show you later. Which is down there, when I put the door on, and I'll show you how we've hidden the screw. But it's only basically if the door's hanging on the sides where the fixings are. I'll basically fix it up, screw that in. With the cramps on there, it's holding it all together so the screw's not pushing the other carcass out. Okay, so leave the clamps on while you're screwing it. That's great. It's always a good idea to get one in the bag. Okay, it's the same again. You put the clamp at the back of the cupboard now. Okay. And where these two cheeks meet, once the work surface goes on, you won't see this screw. Release the clamp. Right, where we fixed this carcass to the wall, when we fixed these two cheeks together, there's no need to put another plate in there because this is basically holding it all together. But it is necessary to put one on there, okay? Right, now we've created our corner, as you can see on here, if you can. We've created a corner to take the sink plates, which we'll do later, yeah? We've come across 600 cupboard. Now, it's quite rare actually. They want a freestanding cooker in here. Normally they're built in with a cutting hob or whatever, or they decide to use ranges. So basically what we've got to do is allow, it's basically 600 appliances are, but they come out about 595, but we're going to leave 600 anyway. So off this cupboard, we're going to leave the top of the space, level it up, because above the cooker we've got a canopy, which again, we'll go through that at a later stage. Basically, we want to leave a space before the next cupboard. See that? 600. Okay. Mark it and just check before doing anything else. It's crucial that the cooker and the canopy run exactly in line. Okay, so. Now I know all these covers are exactly level, but just check at a lower point. Yeah, it's fine, it's 600. So we're going to leave that as a space for the time being. Okay, now we're going to set our next cover up here. But basically, when they measure this kitchen up, they haven't allowed anything. And now what we found, we put the M unit in on a run. I've got a 500 unit and a 600 for a cooker space, which gives me 1100, so we're shy of about 6 to 7 mil. Now what we're going to do, I can't take it from up the other end because we've already stole something. If you can just see where this wall's running out, what we're going to do, ideally, because it's an old building and it's not square, we're going to take out some of this plaster just to about there, down, so we can cock that cupboard into the wall. So basically, I'm hoping to lose that much of the cupboard to gain 6 or 7 mil. We'll do that now. Okay. Customers ordered it himself. Normally, we would have had a smaller unit put in an infill. Like, I'll go through that with you at a later stage. Like an infill about 2 inches coming off the wall. It's far too tight. So when you do measure up, always allow it. I think this was measured before it was plastered, but it's far too tight.